Hello, my name's Trent Roberts, and I'm an associate professor and extension soil fertility specialist with the University of Arkansas System Division of Agriculture. And today, for my online corn field day talk, I'm going to be talking about three scenarios that we've encountered this past season and specifically how to deal with them. So the first one has to do with the historic flooding that we've seen in southeast Arkansas this past June. You know, this is a very atypical situation, but it does relate back to things that we encounter year after year, and that's untimely, high rainfall amounts that will leave many of our fields saturated and waterlogged for extended periods of time. So one of the questions that we've got a lot recently, is there any way that we can predict or determine the amount of nutrients that we've potentially lost, and then be able to go back and add those nutrients later to ensure that our yields are not limiting? So the first thing that I really want to emphasize to everyone is don't do anything until the floodwaters have receded and they are all gone. Your biggest concern when you have saturated soils or flooded soils in your cornfields is actually getting that water removed from the field and allowing the corn to catch its breath and start new root growth before we start to concern ourselves with potential nutrient additions or makeup applications later in the season. Along those lines, I'm going to segue into some of the other work that we've done involving in-season tissue testing and then some other potash tools that we've talked about in other crops that we're migrating into corn. So the next thing that I want to discuss is late season nitrogen applications. In recent years, we've got a lot more questions revolving around pre-tassel applications. And traditionally, we think of those pre-tassel applications going out as urea, via airplane. But more and more we're getting producers interested in the use of Y drops to surface apply UAN 32% as a surrogate for urea in these late season or pre-tassel, tassel timing of applications. So one thing is we use UAN a lot in corn production, but typically we're going to knife that UAN below the soil surface at the side dress growth stage, you know, somewhere around V6 to V8. And so by placing that UAN below the soil surface, we protect it from potential loss mechanisms such as ammonia volatilization. Now, when we think about using UAN at a pre-tassel application timing, those are going to be surface applied. And so similar to the urea that we would put out as a pre-tassel granular application, there's a potential that we could get nitrogen loss to ammonia volatilization. And so part of what we're doing is we're going to go in and start measuring or quantifying ammonia volatilization losses of pre-tassel nitrogen, not only from granular urea, but also the surface applied UAN applications using Y-drop type of system. We've used this quite a bit in rice and wheat and other application timings. And so our goal here is actually to look at different rates and sources of urea surface applied at different timings throughout the corn growing season to determine the loss potential of surface applied urea and urea ammonium nitrate solutions. And these chambers are just a semi-static ammonia volatilization chamber that allow us to quantify the nitrogen loss potential from those surface applied nitrogen sources. So in the coming years, expect to get information on the ammonia volatilization loss potential from these different sources and the potential as to whether or not products such as NBPT would be useful in mitigating or eliminating that nitrogen loss potential from ammonia volatilization. The next thing that I want to talk about is potash applications to corn. And so similar to the crops such as rice and soybean, you've noticed that over the past few years, we've been doing a lot more work on implementing economic potash rate calculators for those other crops. And what we're hoping to do is develop that and implement it in corn. And so the idea behind this is that we would implement things such as soil test K level, we would implement potash fertilizer prices, expected corn value, and use all of those tools together to give us an economic potash application rate. And the nice thing about this is it allows us to go out and apply a pre-plant potash fertilizer rate that we know will maximize our economic profitability. And I think that's very important as we go forward. The other thing is we're continually looking at our application rates for phosphorus and potassium to corn. And we're hoping that we can revise and potentially lower some of those application rates in the coming years. The last thing that I want to talk about is some of the work behind me involving the use of aerial imagery, specifically from drones, to determine if and when we need additional nitrogen applications late season. And by late season, I'm referring to V10 and later. And so what we're going to do is actually walk out in this cornfield, and I'm going to show you a couple of comparisons of plots where from the visual eye, we may not see any differences in the greenness of the plants, but the sensitivity of the drone technology we'll be using can actually pick up those color differences and predict when and where nitrogen applications will be beneficial. One key component of this particular study is actually telling us how much nitrogen we need. So now that we have the leaf tissue analysis, which is a destructive sampling technique, and we have the drone image analysis, which is a non-destructive analysis technique, we can predict when and where nitrogen is needed. The next step is being able to predict how much nitrogen is needed. And so what we're doing with this particular study is matching up specific deficiency levels with different application rates of nitrogen to help determine, you know, if you're at 2.5% nitrogen, what's the required amount of nitrogen added to get you back to that 3% ideal target and your maximum yield potential. So what I'd like to do now is actually take you out and show you some of the plots and some of the visual differences that we can and can't see, and potentially what the drone can and can't see when we're taking an aerial view. So go ahead and follow me into the field here. So actually, here's a good example of one of our plots that has received adequate nitrogen throughout the growing season. And one thing that I want to point out here is that we have good leaf color from the bottom of the plant all the way up to the top leaves. So one thing that we really have to remember is that nitrogen is a mobile nutrient in the plant. And so what that means is that if it starts to encounter a deficiency, it's going to take nitrogen out of these lower leaves and translocate it up to the main growing point or the leaves that are primarily doing the photosynthesis. Once we have an ear leaf like we do on this particular plant, what's going to happen is it's going to put a lot of the photosynthates and the metabolism into this particular leaf because it's what's feeding our ear that's ultimately going to develop and give us our grain yield. So once again, nitrogen is mobile in the plant, and so what it's going to do is pull nitrogen from these lower leaves to the upper leaves to ensure that these solar panels, right, where we're making our sugars, are photosynthesizing at their highest capacity. So one potential problem that poses for aerial imagery are that these upper leaves always tend to be the greenest ones on the plant. And so it's very hard for the naked eye to identify differences in the greenness of the color as we change different nitrogen sufficiency or tissue concentration levels. So what I'd like to do now is actually move down to some of our plots that have a lower nitrogen application rate, and we can start to see some of the visual differences that we can pick up with our naked eye but are very obvious to the drones that we take with the aerial imagery. So what we have here is a side-by-side comparison of a plot where we have no nitrogen additions. So throughout the entire growing season, this plot has actually received no nitrogen fertilizer additions, next to a plot where we've added roughly 75 to 90 pounds of nitrogen during the growing season. And so if you look down at the bottom, the first thing you should be able to notice is the yellowing of these lower leaves, which is synonymous with nitrogen deficiency symptoms. And so this is a good example of where this plant is starting to run out of nitrogen, and it's basically translocating that nitrogen from the lower leaves to these upper leaves. But it's still not enough. So if you notice, if we compare, you know, the greenness of this particular leaf to one that has a higher nitrogen rate, you know, there's a pretty significant difference in the greenness of those two leaves. And it may not be, you know, really easy to pick out with the naked eye, but these differences in the greenness are quite easy for our drone imagery to pick up. And so, you know, that's part of what we're moving towards is figuring out ways to increase the sensitivity of our aerial image analysis so that we can detect these small differences in nitrogen concentration within the corn leaf tissue and then be able to predict when and where that nitrogen application is needed. Like I mentioned before, the key component of this is, okay, we know what the deficiency is. Now, how much nitrogen do we need to get back to maximal yield? As with everything we do, you know, we're going to put economics to it at some point where we determine with, you know, aerial application or ground application, you know, when and where those late season applications, such as a pre-tassel or tassel application, will be profitable for our Arkansas corn producers. As always, if you have questions regarding nutrient management or soil fertility, feel free to reach out to us and we'll do our best to get you the answers you need. Thanks.